Dear student, today we are going to learn one more gland from endocrine system, and that is adrenal gland. So as you all know that adrenal gland is located exactly on the top of the kidney, right? There are two glands, one on the top of each kidney, and that's why we also refer it as a suprarenal gland. Okay, now whenever there is an organ, right, wherever there is a gland, right, this is normally supported by a fibrous capsule, which is made up of a white fibrous connective tissue, right? Fibrous tissue normally are made up of collagen, and they are there for the protection of the delicate structures which are present inside, right? This gland internally is having two part. The surrounding part is referred as cortex, outermost part is referred as a cortex, and inner part is referred as a medulla, right? So two different parts. Again, you can just see that this is the structure, right? On the outer periphery there is a fibrous capsule, then you have the structure that is divided into two anatomical parts. Outer part is cortex. This diagram is a bit confusing because cortex is normally a large component, 80 to 90% component, and medulla is normally a small component, that is only 10 to 20%, okay, which you will also see in the TS or LS of the adrenal gland in the upcoming slide, right? But here you just try to learn that the peripheral region is referred as a cortex, inner region is referred as a medulla, right? As I told you, this medulla is only 10 to 20% of the total gland, and this cortex is 80 to 90%. Normally, this gland are derived from epithelium, and here it is embryonically, it is derived from mesoderm. While medulla is a special type of a tissue, which is actually a specialized type of an post-ganglionic sympathetic nerve, right? If it is a modified neuron, definitely it has to be derived from ectoderm, right? So this is a very special type of a structure which you call as a derived from the neural ectoderm. Okay, again, moving towards the details of the internal structure, as we have discussed, outer portion is referred as a capsule, which is white fibrous connective tissue, right? Now you have two structure, cortex and medulla. As you can see that cortex is a large layer, 80 to 90%, medulla a very small layer, right, that is 10 to 20%. Cortex again is divided in three different parts, right? First part is referred as a zona glomerulosa. Zona glomerulosa is the layer which is able to synthesize mineralocorticosteroids. Remember that all hormones which are synthesized in cortex, they are similar to sterol, right? They are derived from cholesterol actually. OID refers to similar. So they are, because they are similar to steroids, we call it as a steroids. Because they are derived from cortex part, that's why we call it as a corticosteroids. And this corticosteroid, which is important in maintaining the minerals, right? So that's why we call it as a mineralocorticosteroid or mineralocorticoid, right? This is how it is named, right? So if you just know the meaning of name, it is very easy to understand the function also, okay? And major mineralocorticoid, main mineralocorticoid in our body is aldosterone. If you recall your memories, this is the same aldosterone which is important in the RAAS system, renin angiotensin aldosterone system, right? It is same aldosterone, okay? So zona glomerulosa, important function, secretion of mineralocorticoid, that is aldosterone, right? Second layer is zona fasciculata. Zona fasciculata is synthesizing a very important group of hormones which you called as a glucocorticosteroid. Again, steroid we have referred, cortico also because it is from cortex, and glucose because it is involved majorly in the metabolism of glucose, right, or carbohydrate metabolism. So that's why they are referred as a glucocorticoid. It is having a widespread metabolic action, that's why it is referred to as a glucocorticoids, right? There are three major glucocorticoids, that is cortisol, cortisone and corticosterone, okay? All are just similar in their name, just by having different substitution, right, the chemical names are different, right? Otherwise their functions are same. Third layer is zona reticularis, right? Reticule, that means network, right? Here it is anatomical description. Here it is normally columnar cell, right, which are two to three layers. Here there are many layers of polyhedral cells, and here there are irregular cells, right, which makes a network like structure. Because it makes a network like structure, that's why we call it as a reticularis. And this synthesizes very important hormone, which are called as a sex hormone. Here it is very important to note that the major sex hormones of our body, they are synthesized in gonads. Gonads means primary sex organ, that is estrogen and progesterone are synthesized in ovary, and the testosterone is synthesized in the testes. But on a minor amount, these all hormones, progesterone, estrogen and androgen, also are synthesized in the adrenal cortex, right? So this is very important to note, right? Minor portion, right? In that case, they are responsible for maintenance of a secondary sexual characteristic. Okay, so three important layer we have learned, and their hormones that are released, that also we have tried to learn. Okay, adrenal medulla releases adrenaline, right, which is just similar to noradrenaline. Also you have minor release of noradrenaline, also 80% release of adrenaline, 20% release of noradrenaline. Okay, and that is mimicking the effects of sympathetic system, right? So sympathetic response can be created, right, and that leads to release of adrenaline from the adrenal medulla. Okay, so this is again same, you can just see that the internal structure of adrenal gland. Here it's a capsule, zona glomerulosa, then a large layer of a zona fasciculata, zona reticularis, and then adrenal medulla, right? Can you recall the name of hormones from each of the layer? Right, you can just make this video pause and then you can just name it, right, one by one. Zona glomerulosa, it is mineralocorticoid. Zona fasciculata, corticosteroids, glucocorticosteroids. Zona reticularis, it is the sex corticoids, estrogen, progesterone and androgen. And adrenal medulla, it is a special type of a modified neuron, right, postganglionic sympathetic nerve, and it releases adrenaline. Okay, now moving towards the individual, you can say that hormones. But before moving to the individual organ, just there is a revision how these structures are, how these hormones have been named. So again, same thing, involved in the carbohydrate metabolism, that's why glucocorticosteroid. And main glucocorticosteroid is cortisol. Similarly, a hormone which regulates the balance of water and electrolyte, right? Primarily, it is involved in the absorption, reabsorption of sodium from the distal convoluted tubule. That is mineralocorticoids. And major mineralocorticoid, main mineralocorticoid is aldosterone. Okay. Third one is your androgenic steroids, or what you call as a sex corticoids. Right, just to differentiate it from the sex hormones, I am referring it as a sex corticoids, so that I can justify that they are released from the cortex part, right? But as I told you, that's a very minor part of the total anabolic steroids, right, which are, or sex hormones which are released in our body, right? Major part is released from the, as I told you, is released from gonads. Minor part is released from this part. Okay, synonym, it is called as a gonado corticoids. Okay, male hormone that is synthesized and released from adrenal cortex, zona reticularis, is DHEA. DHEA refers to dehydroepiandrosterone, right? Now this is an intermediate actually, which gets converted eventually to testosterone, right? But the major synthesis happens in form of DHEA, which is very important to note here. Okay, female hormone that is synthesized here is progesterone and estrogen, right? These are very famous and very easy to remember, right? So these two are the hormones that are released from the adrenal cortex. Okay, now it is very important, again we have also seen also that these are actually synthesized from the starting material that is required for the synthesis of this hormone is cholesterol, right? And cholesterol, right, even for mineralocorticoids, glucocorticoids, for everything, right, for the all hormones of adrenal cortex, starting material is cholesterol. And through mevalonic acid pathway, which you will learn in biochemistry in the higher semester, this all materials get synthesized, right? Different enzyme assemblies are present in different layers, and that's how these all hormones get synthesized. Okay, so function of these androgenic steroid is growth of axial hair, pubic hair and facial hair during the puberty. Okay, so this is regarding the function. Raw material, as I told you, for synthesis of adrenal hormone is cholesterol, right, which is very important. Normally we consider the role of cholesterol as a bad molecule, right? We consider it as a villain, but it is very important as a raw material for synthesis of all these hormones, right? These hormones are anabolic steroids, right? These hormones are catabolic in nature, right? They are catabolic in nature. Okay, so starting with the glucocorticoid, as I discussed, there are three major forms, right? And out of this, most important is cortisol, right? Corticosterone and cortisone also are the